Hi, 3D printing fans. I'm Marius, and I have something for you, especially if you run Klipper. Let me introduce you to likely the only Ender-3 which has automatic pressure advance calibration. If you have a FDM 3D printer, you know how critical the correct pressure advance setting is for getting clean corners in your prints. I found it a hassle to calibrate every filament manually. Printing test patterns, looking at the lines, saving the settings in the slicer. And dog, that looks like a fun challenge to me. Why waste a few minutes calibrating it manually if I can spend several weeks trying to automate the process? Well, I have it now for the first time in a state where I can share it with you. And I hope you find it useful and it's going to make 3D printing a bit easier for you. Meet Pressure Advance Camera Calibration for Klipper, a tool I developed to automate pressure advance calibration using nothing more than a about 5 euro USB endoscope camera and computer vision. So if you are fed up with calibrating your filament manually like me, this may be the project for you. But keep in mind, it's at an early stage. What's Pressure Advance? Pressure Advance is this awesome Klipper feature that fine-tunes how your extruder behaves when the print head has to speed up, pushing in filament in advance, or slows down, retracting in advance. Get it right and your extrusions have no blobs and gaps. Get it wrong and you're stuck with messy corners and uneven lines. Orca Slicer allows you to print a calibration pattern with which you can manually find out the best setting. But with a cheap endoscope camera, this software can do all the annoying work for you. Here is how it works. At the start of every print, your printer automatically prints a quick test pattern in the corner of the build plate. A series of lines, each with a different pressure advance setting. Then the camera mounted on your printhead snaps a picture of it. The software kicks in and processes the image to remove the background, find the test pattern, crops in on it, and fixes some of the lens distortion, because these budget cameras have not the best quality. Then it finds the smoothest line in the pattern. Now the optimal pressure advance value is set and your printer continues the print like normal. Why I'm excited about this project. First off, it's affordable. You don't need some fancy high-end cameras and or a laser. Just a cheap camera. Second, it's automated, saving you time and guesswork. And third, it's open source under the GPL license, meaning it's free to use, modify or even use commercially. Just share any improvements you make. I poured a ton of work into this and I'm thrilled to see other people use it. To get started, you only need a few things. Hardware-wise, get a cheap USB endoscope camera. Make sure it's full HD and has a flexible cable. There are ones with semi-rigid cables. I guess they don't work for this task. Maybe a webcam would work too, but it needs to be able to focus very close up. Mount it securely on your printhead, pointing straight down at the build plate. In the video descriptions, you will find the mount I designed for my modified Ender 3, which uses the BL Touch mount point. Lighting is super important. Needs to be bright enough for a clear shot, but no glare where the test pattern prints. Also, the BL Touch red light is not helping. Oh, and when you first plug in the camera, check its orientation. Rotate it 90 degrees counterclockwise so the lines run top to bottom in the image. That maximizes resolution for the software. It's easiest to connect it first to your phone and orientate it correctly before hooking it up to the printer. Now onto the software side. There are a few straightforward steps. You will clone the project's Git repository to your printer's computer. Symlink the script to Klipper's extras folder to introduce two new G codes to Klipper. install some Python dependencies, and tweak your printer's configuration file with settings like the camera offsets. But these are not so critical, we just need them to automatically position the camera roughly over the pattern. You also have to add your own inference ABI key. I will explain that in a second. And configure your slicer to call these new G codes. Don't worry, I've got detailed instruction over on the GitHub project site, so head there for the full rundown. With these cheap cameras and the reflective build plate, it's surprisingly challenging to remove the background with old-school computer vision algorithms like thresholding and graph cutting. I tried it for weeks, but unfortunately the results were very unreliable. Just the daylight changing on my unenclosed printer made it fail. That's why I switched to using artificial intelligence. A state-of-the-art open segmentation model which gives good results. Unfortunately, it uses way too much resources to be run on a Raspberry Pi-like single-board computer. So instead I use a cloud inference service where the printer uploads the image to and gets back an image with the background removed, which helps my software process the printed test lines. That's why you need to supply your own ABI key. Costs less than a cent per print, and it seems like you get $1 credit when you sign up. So very affordable, but I would love to ditch this and run a local model on the printer itself in the future. But for now, until I have enough data to train our own smaller model, for this task we need to use the external server. Things to watch out for. This works best with good contrast between your filament and the build plate. If they are too similar, or if lighting is bad, the software will struggle, just like your eyes would. Also, this is an early version, so double check the results manually at first to make sure it's dialed in for your setup. You will find some debug output in the Klipper console. I'm so excited about where this project can go. But I need your help to get there. If you find it useful or interesting, consider supporting me. Links are in the description. Every bit helps me spend more time improving this project and keep making more content. Plus, this tool saves every image it captures in a subfolder called Images. If you're up for it, send those to me by email or upload them to the repository. I created an issue for it. Please check that there is no private info before sending. Those pictures will help me train a future model to run locally, and we need tons of examples to make it happen. So that's the Pressure Advance Camera Calibration for Klipper project. Want to try it? Head over to the project's GitHub page for the code and step-by-step setup instructions. This is an early stage project. So your feedback, tweaks, or contributions are crucial. Also another idea. Maybe it would be possible to mount a high-quality camera in a fixed position, looking at the build plate, and calibrate the camera once with a checkerboard to unwarp the distortions, instead of mounting it on the printhead. But I have not tried that yet. Thanks for watching. If you like this, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe for more updates and more projects, and share it with your maker buddies. Looking forward to your feedback in the comments. Thanks and bye.